Hello,
my. Wait.
How is?
Tweeting out that we're tweeting. Live.
Hold on, I can get a last bite in.
We're already.
Guys, we're already live.
No, what? We're not until I tweet it. No,
you
now
could,
we are.
Couldn't
we're
you tweet that like right before we go live?
They don't know how to get here.
I didn't know he was doing all this, so I got it ready.
You absolutely knew that I was doing all this.
Hello, my friends.
Hold on. You're not really live until you tweet about it. It's kind of like.
So we weren't live until like 4 minutes
like
in last time.
It's kind of like the tree
huh?
falls in a forest, but if no one's around, does it make a sound kind of thing? You know what I mean? Like, if you don't publicize that you have a stream, do you have a stream? You know what I mean? It's like Carson Daly's TV show. If it's on mm-hmm. at 2 a.m. and no one knows about it, do you have a TV show?
He does have mm-hmm. a TV show, and it's great. It's a great TV show. Shout out,
what's
Carson.
It called?
What's I'm
it called?
Watching.
What's it called, Sean?
Live with Carson Daly.
Inside Out with Carson Daly.
Live with Carson Daly.
Total Request then.
It's live, which is interesting because it's at 2 o'clock in the morning, so he's to stay up super late. And then work
Total
on the Today
late.
Show the next morning. So I'm not envious of you, Carson Daly.
Now, my favorite thing Carson Daly has done is last year he dresses Linus. Can we show it on Tuesday?
Uh-huh.
Show
yeah.
an image. You know what? Commit to a full 2 minutes of this image and
yeah,
just
okay.
set to music. That's it. Here we go. Here it is. Go ahead. Hey, welcome back. Like, wasn't that... That got
that
me in the
great.
Halloween spirit.
That was great.
That got me in the Halloween spirit. Mm. I'm fucking ready for Halloween.
Sorry.
Yeah.
I'm ready for Halloween.
Yeah.
So, 31 days of Halloween. That's what I say when October 1st comes.
Yeah.
I go, 31 days of Halloween.
That's my birthday
you
month.
You know...
31 days. Every day I'm going to wear a fucking pumpkin thing. Every day I'm going to wear a pumpkin thing. And I'm going to go, hey guys, are you... Get ready... 31 days of Halloween. Halloween the 2nd. That's what I say on October 2nd.
It's like a countdown.
Kind of a fun thing that I do.
Well, theme song, I guess.
Welcome back.
Welcome. Welcome back.
No,
welcome.
Someone in the chat just said this is going to be a long podcast. It is. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
We are playing for time tonight.
Time, no laughs. You don't care about that.
Yeah. The comedy, that's priority 2. Priority 1 is length.
Length.
Get your money's
this
worth.
This is exactly in the Garrett School of Economics. Get your money's worth. Longer is better. And we got plenty of length for you tonight. On this Sunday. Anyway, welcome. This is podcast 303. Tight jeans, Jenny
Dukes. We were, I was editing the podcast 411. I was making the thumbnail for it.
Wow.
And then I thought, Eric's made that podcast 311 joke now for 100 podcasts.
100 podcasts.
I want to start this podcast off right and
yeah.
say the right stuff.
Good.
We need to pay some respect to someone who deserves it. This is kind of breaking news now, so it's not quite made it the rounds
Thank
or
you.
Anything yet. But it's not, no, none of you fucking people. It is someone who...
Whoa.
Is probably going to be in the record books. A famous thing on the internet, kind of a meme situation.
Oh, we got a meme
I don't really dabble in memes
yeah, I don't know
too
those.
Much, but is the chair flipping challenge where kids will take a plastic chair and flip it and try to hopefully it lands.
That's the thing.
Suck.
They do it. It's a big in New Zealand.
Are
big
you talking
in
about
New
the
Zealand.
Bottle?
No.
No, the bottle. That's
the
out.
Bottle.
That's out.
What
now
are
we
you
flip chairs.
That's
old?
Out.
Yes,
that's out.
Man.
Yep.
Yeah, what do you dab to? Fuck off. All right.
What's that?
The chair flipping challenge, and I want to say congratulations to Sean Chatfield.
Oh.
First time chair flipper.
Thank you, guys.
First time wow. chair flipper, and it was caught. Ladies and gentlemen, history in the making. Mm. We were on a second episode of YouTubers React. It aired today.
Did it? I didn't know.
YouTubers React to chair flipping.
Yeah.
We made it. We made it twice. How many people have had careers where they could say they made it twice?
Not
many. Our 15 minutes of fame has become a month because this guy on camera, they showed him a challenge video, and then they were like, can you try it? And Sean flipped it, and he's the first person. He nailed it.
Mm-hmm.
You show all these other YouTubers, and they have to do it 8 times. Oh, this guy nailed
holy
it.
Shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
This guy nailed it.
Thank
flipped
you.
One.
What Thank was that you. Like?
It felt good. It felt good.
Was it easy? I mean, you're an athlete.
It was easy because I am an athlete.
You keep your body toned.
Hold on. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. Glacier2Win in the chat says meh.
Okay.
Glacier2Win, I have our Twitch resources on the line, and we will find out your name and address, and there will be legal consequences for what you just said.
Meh.
I will not. I am proud of his accomplishment.
Thank you.
I'm proud of what he did.
Thank you.
And I'm proud of what it means for Mega 64 going forward. And if you're not, I will prosecute to the fullest extent of the law, and I'll make stuff up to make it even worse.
You will.
So enjoy your life of hell.
Yeah.
Enjoy hell itself.
To go after Sean.
Anyway, so he flipped the chair.
Thank you. I flipped the chair. So thank you very much.
He did a really good job.
Now, I see like a pattern here. Now, I don't know if this is like an Illuminati kind of thing. We'll see if it happens a third time. But you were on table flip twice.
Yeah.
And now you.
How many times did you flip a table? Never.
Never. And then you go on and you do two reacts and you first try do a chair flip.
Wow. That is some Illuminati
stuff. So what's the third trifecta here coming on? Maybe CNN debate, the fourth debate?
Car flip.
No, what's going to happen is when the winner of the presidential election is decided, I'm going to show it via hologram.
Coin toss.
Like Will.i.am did back in the day.
Coin flip. Dude.
And I am going to just flip shit hologram on CNN because we have a new president. It's exciting. So,
Do you think we really have a new president?
Probably not. Probably the same one.
I think everyone's going to bail. Anyway.
New system. Put a new governmental system.
Anyway, check out Sean did chair flip. Check me out. We have a clip.
Oh.
Next week, I'll be on car flip. Check it out. All right, we're back. That's just a little
teaser.
For what I'm going to be doing. So check that out. Anyway, good stuff. Well, we have a little more time.
It's not over yet.
What do you guys think so far? Email podcast@megasysmore.com on what you think of the show so far. Mm. Just a general idea of where you think it's at, where it could go. Where it could go.
I played some video games. We can talk about that if you want.
Shit.
If you want.
Now let's move on.
I played the demos on the VR that came with the VR.
Sure.
Could have said that better, but it's fine. And then I was playing it late at night, and there was one called Rush of Blood or something like that.
Mm.
I got to the fucking menu on that and checked the fuck out. I was so scared I couldn't do that one.
Really?
So yeah,
Rush of Blood.
Maybe
is it
whatchamacallit? Ah, fuck.
It's the horror game that really has no tie.
Yeah, what's the thing?
I don't remember the name of it either. But
I'm blanking
Sony.
Out. I've played it. The thing Same where here. Your kid's in the fucking woods.
It's that fucking forgettable.
I don't know.
I don't know. The chat will probably...
Oh my god, how can I not think of this? This is
no, seriously, I played that game too, and it's...
Until Dawn.
Until Dawn, yeah.
Until Dawn, Rush of Blood, right? Yes, that's what it is.
Aside from impressive graphics, that Until Dawn
I did
Dawn
not
game,
like that game.
No.
Isn't that weird? Everyone told me to like play that and stream it.
Yeah,
and,
not interesting.
I didn't care. It was like... You know, it played a little bit like Heavy Rain to me.
Yeah.
But Heavy Rain has this melodrama, and honestly, some good directing. I'll be real. Some. But it's melodramatic to a point that does make it fun. This was just this, I don't care about these kids in the woods. Let them all die. I don't care. I didn't really want to play.
Yeah.
Not Mr. Robot.
But anyway, this is a spinoff of
that. It was like on like a rail and you're in this like, I think it's like a haunted house or not, like a carnival ride situation.
See, I don't know why.
And something jumped out at me and I was like, fuck this. Yeah. I can't, I'm too scared.
I don't know why they called it Until Dawn, Rush of Blood, because I don't think it has anything to do with Until Dawn.
I don't know.
Other than maybe the
same
developer
or something? Some kind of spinoff of it. But that's funny that you mention scary jumping things or whatever. I want to see if anybody out there agrees with me or can relate to this or whatever. I don't think a lot of people here, I know Eric did, at least to a degree, play Arkham Knight. Arkham Knight. The latest Batman was Arkham Knight.
Yeah, I played that.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So now what I'm playing, I just played through Batman Arkham VR, which I talked about last week. Did a great job. It's short, but it does such a great job. It like, man, I am in the world of Batman. Like, man, the cave is so fully realized, and I'm in Gotham, and I'm whatever, and it feels so real and tangible. It's great. So I finally played through it. What is this fucking jump scare shit that Rocksteady is in love with?
Yeah. Terrible. Well,
the last act of this VR thing is a bunch of fucking cheap jump scares and shit. And then, you remember that, Eric. In Arkham Knight, there was a bunch of that shit.
Yeah, I remember there was... It didn't seem like it fit the rest of the game, but for some reason, there was a lot of that stuff.
And they did the same shit in the VR thing.
Now I don't want to do the VR.
But that doesn't surprise me.
I just don't understand what is there... To be totally real, that knocked that game down a couple pegs for me. The Arkham Knight, going back to Arkham Knight, I felt like it was constantly trying to do these dumbass jump scares. And you don't need to add any to this podcast, please. Let the people have peace.
I would never do that.
Let the people have peace.
I would never do that again.
Yeah, what? You do have to put that in there.
He does that. I want to go on record. I'm saying that I hate jump scares. This guy doesn't.
You know, there was a podcast two or three podcasts ago that we were talking about jump scares, and I thought, I'm going to have the music quietly go up so people are ready for it, and then it never happens. And it never did happen.
So you just made people anxious.
Yeah, I want people anxious.
Look at you. So, I like that.
Yeah, so, thank you. It's kind of anyway, I just terrorism. Think... I think we talked about it. I think we talked about it on the podcast, didn't we? How you could do fun jump scares. You can make them fun. But these things where you're just doing stuff and, you know, is like, okay. And Arkham Knight was actively annoying with that shit. Yeah. I'd fly around and then Man-Bat would fucking fuck my face. And it's like,
that's not what you want.
So, anyway, no. Rocksteady, hey, you're a great developer. You don't need that. Stop doing that. That is so, like... juvenile to me. It's like, wow, look at.
Maybe there was some
the penguins in your face. Whoa.
There was probably some market research where they're like, yeah, people just enjoy jump scares in movies, and let's put it in these.
But why does Batman have to be scary? Like, what makes Batman scary? It can be dark. Why is it scary?
I don't think it does. I think it's strictly like, hey, we have this new platform VR. You can do jump scares, and it's like you're really there.
But they did it in the game that didn't have VR. Like, what? I just don't. Yeah. I don't get it.
So
anyway,
that I played, didn't get very far into it, but my story goes, so it's like midnight when I'm playing, because it's hard to play VR when the kids are around because they want to fuck it up and play with it, whatever, and they can't.
They can be setting things on fire while you can't look.
The first time I tried it, one of the kids ran past me and tripped on the wire, so I decided no more kids. And then, so it's late, all the lights are off, I'm playing that game, and then I got scared, and I took off my VR headset. And I'm playing, my TV's right here, my little hallway's right there, and Lennon is standing in the hallway just looking at me, and scared, didn't say anything, scared the shit out of me.
Holy shit.
It was the scariest thing I've ever experienced.
They're here.
Oh, fuck that. Kids can be terrifying in the middle of the night, for the record. But then I played a game, Thumper, and that game was rad. I really, really liked it. I bought the game. You know, I liked Rez a lot when I played the demo of it, but I got a little motion sick. Just a little bit. And I did not at all with Thumper. I'm like, I'll give this a shot. And I really, really liked it. Or am liking it, I should say.
I was going to say on that subject, I beat Rez
Oh, wow.
I didn't have any time to play VR past the initial thing that we talked about last week. Because we were wrapping up, honestly, this new Blu-ray we've been working on. But that's done now, so I had time. And I played all the rest of Rez, including the new level that they added. They added whole new stuff for this game.
Really?
Just for PS4. And I was just gonna say, never got any motion sickness from anything VR so far. The last level of that got me.
Oh really?
Not so bad that I had to stop or oh my god or anything. It wasn't. But there's a boss that you're essentially chasing or running alongside, and it was like, wait, is he gone? Is he gone? Oh, he's back here. Oh god, oh he's going over me. Oh, he's going back. Oh, fuck.
It's moving a lot.
Yeah, so it was a little hairy, I have to say. I'd never experienced that.
I think that when this goes on a little bit longer, they'll figure out what makes people sick and what doesn't make people sick.
Yeah.
And I know I'm probably a little more sensitive to that than the average person, but that game was totally fine, and but I went to that video player. What is that VR video thing? Vridio. Cool name.
Vridio.
Blue icon? Like a blue? Yeah, okay.
There's a couple players like
that. I would have named that, honestly.
I've downloaded it, but I haven't seen it yet. I haven't opened it.
But that sucks because it's...
yeah.
It you definitely get sick in that. Like, it's someone like filming, and like they hit the camera, and someone's like, and like it, the camera starts tilting, and I'm like, fuck this. Like,
oh, really?
Yeah,
it just, I didn't encounter anything like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, it was just terrible. It was terrible.
Did a couple of things that I looked at were very stationary. They didn't really move.
What? Did your kids try the VR? Like, what did they think of
it? Not for ages well, it says 12 and under.
12 and under, but I think, well, Emma's 11.
Dude.
So I figured that's close enough.
Ooh, you're going to jail.
Oh, I'm going to jail. Fuck. She played for probably like 5 minutes. She did that headmaster game where you do the headers in the prison, which is a little, it was cool.
She plays soccer.
Yeah, she liked it. Sawyer looked at the ocean for probably 30 seconds, and Beckett did the same thing. But like, they just wanted to see what it was, and then they thought it was cool, but that was really it. I have heard people saying, like, definitely don't have your kids under 12 play this. Like, really, really don't. So I don't know. Like, I don't know if I will let them play it. I don't know. I don't want to fuck them up, but
I think it's worth the risk.
It's worth the risk, right? Because they got to see those sharks.
They got to roll the dice.
I remember going to Tokyo Disney with a whole bunch of people, and there was a pregnant woman in the group. And then right at the only at the end of a 2-hour line was there a sign saying pregnant women can't go on this. And it was like, oh, great. And I was Mr. Funny, and I was like, it's worth it, though. It's so cool. And they were like, Rocco, no. I don't really think
there was a game days that we were in line for. I think Jenny was pregnant with Lennon, and we were in the line for Star Tours, and some ladies that we wasn't with our group was like, you've been on this ride? And she's like, yeah. I've been on the ride. I think like, she wants to like, ask questions about it. And she's like, I mean, that's pretty irresponsible of you to go on this ride. And Jenny's like, well, I haven't gone today. I've been on... Okay, whatever. Just go away.
Oh, wow. Just go away.
Anyways. But that's the game that I play. I played Thumper. And I've really, really, really enjoyed that game. I recommend it highly.
Yeah, that's cool. I got to try some more of that. I tried the demo. It was cool.
I tried the demo. I feel like Thumper got overhyped for me.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Because when I played it, I was like... this is fun on the demo. It's like a rhythm game, but I can see how this starts to get really hard and I can't pass this, like, I'm going to get to a brick wall maybe. I feel like it's one of those games. Mm-hmm. Then I played Rez, and because I bought Rez Infinite as well. Mm-hmm. And then that was like, oh, well, this is everything else I wanted. Like, I'm not interested in Thumper after trying Rez.
I
might go back.
I think Thumper is fun, but I don't crave that in VR as much as I only really want to do, like I said last week, just kind of like big worlds and stuff in VR. Like, I don't really care to play that as much.
I
want to
shoot motherfucking guns.
Wow.
And that's it.
I haven't used the Move controllers at all. That's thinking about it. What is there anything with demos that use that?
Well, yeah. Batman isn't entirely that.
Oh, I haven't played that.
The heist thing is also entirely.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
The heist shooting gallery is really fun. But I don't want to buy that game just for the shooting gallery. That's like the lamest part.
I felt like PS Worlds has been pretty disappointing.
Yeah, I don't care about PS Worlds. Nothing in that really... Like,
yeah, the shark thing was a cool demo, but that could have been on the demo disc,
exactly.
I thought.
Yeah, I agree.
And they had like a game where it's like you're moving your mask to like head a ball comes to your face. Yeah. It's kind of like a Tron-looking thing.
That's fun for a minute.
Yeah, but yeah, for a minute. Yeah. And then the luge thing sucked, I thought.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think the whole thing was kind of like, I don't
Yeah,
really...
I didn't need that. No. There were demos I had more fun with.
Oh, yeah, honestly. Definitely.
But yeah, going back to Rez, that was everything I wanted out of VR. Played through the game, the main game. I've played it before, but this made it a whole new experience. But man, the new areas that they added incredible. It changes the graphical style completely because this whole game is all very geometric and grid and this and
PS2,
that.
PS2, right?
Yes. Dreamcast first.
And this is kind of a remaster. I mean, it's Rez Infinite, but it's like a remaster of the first game.
Right. Plus more shit.
Plus this new stuff that you're talking about that totally opens the book.
This new stuff is the art style and like the physicality of everything changes, and it's all particle. It's like the stars of the universe start fucking forming your gameplay. And so everything, it's kind of the same, similar gameplay, but it's all particle based. So things are just made out of stars and stuff. And it's all like modern day graphics, like pushed to the extreme. And the controls are even a little bit different to where like you're like the original game, you're kind of on rails and you just kind of shoot stuff as you're on rails.
Right.
But this, it's like, yeah, you're floating through the middle of the fucking universe. And use your headset to fly over here and here, and now I'm going over here. It was so trippy. It was awesome. It was so cool. That we need another res. Just they have the engine now of that last thing.
Right.
Just make another one. Just make another one in that style.
What if they do DLC? That's just more levels in.
Yeah, I mean the game is cheap. Add more shit. Yeah. Nobody's gonna complain. Hmm. I don't think.
I would really like to see something that's like, because I played that Battle Zone, which is like tanks.
Yeah.
And I've played another one that was kind of piloting a ship with kind of guns on the outside of it. But I'm really looking forward to the first, like, mech game.
Yeah.
Because getting into a big,
I wish Titanfall
thing
had it. Yeah.
That you can see, like, I'm an EVA pilot, the controls in front of me and the seat when I look down. And looking out of my display where I have, like, my ammo here and what weapons I have. Something like that, but where you're piloting a cooler mech than just, like, a tank. Like, that Battlezone game, I think that's the first step, but I don't want to buy that at retail. I might get that later. But something I'm looking forward to, something that, I mean, aside from shooting guns, something that I can pilot a ship.
Yeah.
Or I want to try, I haven't done any of the flying stuff, like the EVE Online.
Yeah. There, I think a lot of that stuff is going to, dude, it's, not to even plug our, that we have our own shit going on, but it's a month until Black Friday. Just about. I think so much of those, so many of those VR games are going to be cheap on Black Friday.
I bet you're right.
Cool. I would think.
Even and digitally, Cyber Monday maybe.
I don't know. I'm not sure.
Have to wait.
But yeah. Well, no, Digital Tuesday. I think it's fucked up.
It is. I apologize. It's fucked up Wednesday.
It's okay. I just don't want people to get confused. Right. You know. But anyway. No.
Yeah. People are saying that I should play Riggs. That's what I'm looking for. It's not. I don't think that's quite there.
I don't even know anything about that.
Riggs, it's like they made it an NFL sport, and you get in mechs and fight other dudes.
Really?
Yeah, and it wasn't like me with a move control. I don't know. If it's something like that where I'm not like in a giant mech, I'm like in a kind of suit thing, I want to be able to aim with the move controller still. I'll do controller stuff if I'm piloting something, but anything that feels like an extension of my arm, I want to aim with the move controller.
Speaking of mech stuff, you know, one of my favorite games of this generation that went, you know, relatively under the radar. I mean, not that it was totally under the radar, but it was an Xbox One exclusive, was Titanfall.
Yeah.
And it was like, okay, they're going to make Titanfall 2, and it won't be exclusive, and it's going to be so, it's going to be amazing. Yeah. And it finally comes out this week. Later this week, Titanfall 2 comes out, and I can't get it. I have so many other games to play.
Oh, yeah. Man.
I can't justify getting that right now. Like, maybe Christmas or something like that. I don't know, but...
It's on PS4, too?
It's PS4, yeah. Wow. And I know it's going to be awesome. I mean, the first one was great. It was just a little limited in what it had and things like that, but I can't justify getting that right now. Like, there's so much stuff.
I'll see how reviews are.
Yeah,
I didn't know. I had no idea it was coming out this week.
Yeah,
I thought it was coming out to in January.
No,
jeez.
I think October 28th.
I didn't know that Battlefield 1 came out. Everyone was so excited.
That came out quietly
to
me. Yeah,
and then everyone was stoked. And then I found out it was already out. I was very surprised.
Yeah, I was surprised by that too. But let's talk about the big video game news from this week.
Ooh.
Nintendo showed their brand new console, the Nintendo Switch.
Hmm.
So,
thoughts?
What do you think? Thoughts?
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 Thoughts? Yeah.
This.
so much this.
So much this.
So much this.
Fucking this.
I fucking love science.
I fucking love science. I fucking love science.
Stop.
Anyway, okay, yeah, go ahead. Oh, I forgot he had headphones on. Yeah. Sorry. Anyway,
torture.
Yeah,
right to Eric. That's fucking cool. I don't know.
Yeah,
yeah. I'm into just Nintendo. You can't keep up with the big boys, as far as graphics. As far as
I don't think it's even a matter of can't. It's they don't have any desire to.
There's this fucking arms race with the two big kids on the block.
Yeah.
And Nintendo's going, hey, let those two assholes fight it out. Let's just keep innovating gameplay.
Yeah.
The graphics are going to be good enough, but let's innovate on gameplay and, in this case, like hardware. And as a hardware fan, fuck yeah. Like, I want something that does all that shit and controllers go on the sides of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's basically how I feel. It's funny because I've read a couple things and a few articles or whatever online that were kind of like, you know, oh, surprise, there isn't a big kind of like insinuating there wasn't like a big innovation here. Like there is a really big innovation here. And I was like,
I thought, really? You know, and, take that and, game
but,
anywhere.
But they would talk, but they would, but like, you know, and it, Derek kind of said something like that too. And I was like, what are you talking about? But he's like, oh, just in terms of the gameplay. And I was like, yeah. Oh, so, okay, in terms of gameplay, I get that, because it looks like they all control fairly standard.
Right.
I get that, but I feel like we kind of keep saying that. Where's the next gameplay innovation? But it's like, I feel like everything Nintendo puts out gets this reaction of, can you just make this fucking regular? You know, like Star
That's
Fox.
That's not why people
Star
love
Star Fox,
Nintendo.
They go out of the way to go, okay, here's the, well, it uses the Wii controller, the Wii U controller, yeah. And you could see inside the cockpit from the thing. And what did everyone say? Oh, just fucking give me one with normal controls. So I kind of feel like what they did was, okay, well, let's not fuck with tried and true gameplay and rather use innovation to make it. Let's spend our innovation card on making it conducive to your life.
Right.
You know what I mean? And so for that, I love it. This is everything I wanted in a new console, yeah. Period. Power aside, like, I expect a PlayStation to be really powerful and this and that. But that's not what I expect from Nintendo. I want more fun games. But also, like, having this to be able to take that anywhere, that is... I'm not speaking for anybody else. Just speaking for myself.
Yeah.
That is... I want that so bad. I've always... wanted that kind of thing when they put out the Final Fantasy X remake and the Metal Gear Solid remake, yeah. And they had like the transfer ring thing, yeah. Where you could play your save.
This is like the easiest way to do
you
that.
You could continue a game on a Vita and then play it at home. Was such a great experience for me because I could continue games when we were traveling, when I'm at the office, all that stuff. I know some people don't carry portable game systems or aren't into that, and so they won't maybe get that much out of it. But I do, and I fucking love it. I'm so happy.
I don't play portable games that often.
Right.
But I would I think I'd be much more inclined to, like, I'm going to soccer practice for an hour, so I sit there. So why not take my Zelda game that I'm in the middle of with right. me and play right
Dude,
there?
So sick.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm like? With the 3DS, like, well, I got to make a new game. You know, it's not the same. Whatever.
Sure.
But this is like, well, I was playing at home and now I have to go, but I'm could keep playing the same game. That's awesome. That's so cool.
And that was my next kind of thought on it was, because I know a lot of people who are like, I don't know, though. I love the Nintendo consoles, but I don't really play, like, 3DS and stuff. And I just wonder how... It's one thing to be like, I just don't want to bring the device out. Okay, fine. But I wonder how much of that is that you... That yeah, like, DS games and 3DS games are... kind of smaller, lesser experiences.
They
like,
are. I
like,
think.
Those games yeah. are a little... I mean, I love those consoles, for the record, on my behalf, but the fact that, you know, you've never really had the ability to take console-worthy things before.
Right.
Like, you'll make time to play the new Zelda on
right.
a console,
right.
but you might not if it's, you know... the
Phantom
you know,
Hourglass.
Yeah, Phantom Hourglass.
Oh, yeah. No, I will.
You know, and I wonder how many people are... in right. that same boat. You
Even
know
like
I mean?
The, showing the people on a plane playing this game. It's yeah. like, yes, that's...
Well, I was fucking remoting, fantasizing over that part.
Remoting
that
out
part.
The controller and then setting the kickstand up to, yeah. to use it as like a little mini display.
Oh, God.
That's fucking rad.
I'm all over that.
That's like a hybrid console where yeah. You're not really portable at that point.
Right.
Because you're setting up a little display right. and you're holding a controller, but it's not truly like yeah. a home console.
Right. Exactly.
It's this weird middle ground, but that's super interesting.
I remember seeing when the Wii U came out, a soldier came back from overseas
yeah.
and got somehow in his shipment or on the way there, whatever, a Wii U. Like, it had just come out, and he got on the plane. I remember someone on Reddit posted this. He got on the plane. It was a powered plane. Mm-hmm. He plugged in the Wii U console and yeah. ran it and played it off the controller the entire, like, eight-hour flight.
Awesome.
And I remember thinking, man... I wish there was a like easier way to do that. That's so cool. You know, whatever.
Yeah, it's a big,
yeah.
bulky thing to bring
yeah,
around.
I love,
but now,
yeah, I love that. I fantasize about long flights so I can fucking beat games. No one can fucking call me or you know, I don't get the in-flight yeah. internet. I just like, I'll beat a Final Fantasy.
I wonder
game,
how long whatever. The battery's going to be for this.
So that's the question. I think it comes down a lot to the specs and stuff.
Yeah,
Nike
like
will make a backpack.
Exactly. Now, when are they going to talk about that?
How much is, honestly... A big thing for me, too, is how durable is the thing. Like yeah. looking at that screen, I can't, you know, the Vita, I carry on me, and it's fine.
Right.
I couldn't do that with the Wii U. The Wii U screen, I've barely hit that thing, and I had to replace Like,
right.
You know,
so, like, but like an iPad, you can get a case for it. Maybe it'd be the same kind of thing.
Well, I got a case for my Vita that folds over the top of it, so it covers
It's just funny, like, bringing up the Vita, though. It's like, I was so sad about... I really liked the Vita as a system. Yeah, it didn't get supported that much, but just the system, it was like, man, such a... This is what I like. Like, I love the 3DS, but man, a big-ass widescreen with great controls was so awesome, and I just thought, man, that failed, and we'll never get... a follow-up, and it's like, well, and now Nintendo's kind of making it a little bit, you know, but it works because it's within their, you know, they have owned outside of mobile games on a phone, they own any kind of portable gaming, and they're the ones making it, so it's awesome. I'm super stoked about that.
Yeah, it's gonna be interesting if they start seeing a loss of market with their Nintendo 3DS or whatever the next portable, or is there going to be even a next?
I feel like this is the replacement for both.
Well, it's like, almost, it's like this merging. Do they stop doing? Is there going to not be a new 3DS XL?
I don't think there will. To be honest, like I see this as their solution to both. You know what I mean? It's like, okay, yeah, what's the new Nintendo console? But they're portable. I mean, the 3DS did awesome, but it still did less than the DS. Like, you know, that market is changing, and now they have something that I think brings a force in both departments.
Yeah, because they can't compete with little app games that are on people's phones.
But there will always be.
Well, shit. Hey, you just answered it. Nintendo just started making apps for the fucking iPhone and Android.
Yeah. So they're in that market.
Their mobile resource going to the new platform, which is just cell phones.
Yeah.
And they are going to just kind of absorb, I guess, what would be 3DS gaming into the
I think they're making it all. And, you know, a lot of people commented on that the promo video that they put out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's one of the, and this is another thing that Derek said, was he was just like, it's kind of weird. Like, you're not even, like, showing the, like, kids playing this? Like, you know, why don't they, why are they dancing around that?
True. I was waiting. That's the thing I wanted to bring up.
Yeah.
There were no kids. Yeah, there were no families.
No.
It was strictly young professionals.
The Wii U was all
families. Hey, I'm going to play go-karts and then go-karts.
Yeah. And
dude,
then
guy in the airport met that smoking hot chick who was playing hers.
But
they instantly were like,
all sitting on the ground.
That girl who was playing in her apartment by herself and her friends are having a party across the street on the roof.
That is the worst part of that commercial.
She's going to go over.
Oh, what's that?
You guys don't have roof parties.
I don't have this.
Oh, I am every day. But I was going to say, that promo video I thought was very effective and peaked at him on the plane.
The plane, after the plane, I tuned out. It was awful.
Hey, because through that, I was like, fuck, yes, this is what I wanted. And then it was like, what? Oh, we're on the roof. Okay, it was like 10 more examples that I didn't need. Yeah.
Yeah.
But I was with it.
I want me and my friends to play at the park and get robbed at 10:30 at night. You guys don't want to play NBA 2K17 and get shot?
Sit down right there covered in sweat and play NBA Jam.
But they did show, I was super excited about Splatoon 2 or whatever the next Splatoon
was. Whatever
that
may be, we don't know.
But like,
esports.
Here's the thing. I fucking hate that they made it we're going to be in esports.
Yeah,
no, you're fucking not. No, you're fucking not.
Yeah.
You're not going to have esports, Nintendo. I'm sorry. Maybe on Melee? But that's it. Or Brawl or whatever the fucking old one that everyone plays is.
I think it's Melee.
Yeah, I had it right the first time.
Has everyone been yelling, can you hook a GameCube controller up
here? You need a dongle.
Give it time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm excited about is to play a Wii at home and I have to go like this with my hand trying to find where my little cursor is for the longest time.
Yeah.
Little annoyances like that, it's like, it was cool in 2005, and now it's like, all right, guys, I don't know. It's from right here.
Yeah, my whole thing with it is I hope they can, you know, I buy Nintendo's machines. This is another thing I just want to bring up is, you also see all this conversation that's like, cool system, it looks cool, but you know, they better get the third parties this time. They better keep the third parties. Fucking give up on that. Like, that whole third-party thing... won't have games with third parties, but this thing, like, I should have... Why can't the new Grand Theft Auto be on the Nintendo... That's over, man. Like, that whole battle is lost. Like, every system they put out, there's this thing of... This should have the new Mass Effect on it! You get that from your PlayStation or your PC. Like, that. Right. Like, Nintendo makes... a Nintendo machine, and I don't think there's anything wrong with that
at
all.
Did they show at any point a disc going into this thing?
Oh, it's
not?
A cartridge.
They popped the cartridge in.
It was a cartridge. Oh, yeah. Did I miss that part?
It is.
You did, yeah.
They focus in on that,
and he pops it in, yeah.
They don't really drive it home. Cartridge. It's one scene, yeah.
Well, it looks like a little...
Oh, they did?
Yeah. It looks like a... Well, it was. To be fair, it was never totally sure, but it sounded like it was. But it's like it was almost like a card, yeah.
Isn't it funny that I remember the girl going to have that party on the roof, but I can't remember the cartridge thing, so... Mm.
You only focus on the negative.
I guess
I think it's going to have a really strong digital marketplace as well. I think that's what they'll push. I mean, the Wii U already does almost every game you can get for download as well.
I hope that this one, though, does feel a little more connected, because, you know, it's like the Wii came out at a time with 360 and PS3, and that was the birth of really like true online. Yeah. There was online before, but those systems brought it where it's like, wow, I see all my friends here. I can talk with people. Oh, it made it very social.
Fucking friend code.
Yeah, that was a thing.
And you felt very connected to everything. And the Wii was, okay, well, fine, whatever. Nintendo's doing their own thing. But the Wii U, it was frustrating because it was kind of a step further. And there were games that actually were like, cool, it would be cool to play Mario Kart with Sean or anybody. And it's still just difficult enough that I wouldn't do it. You know, it was slow getting that to connect. And then it's like, wait, I don't... It just wasn't... It still wasn't quite there. You know what I mean? And I kind of hope that that's a little more solid with this one. Otherwise, I just wanted to play Nintendo games. That's what I'm looking for. And they showed a new Mario that is very Mario 64 style.
Yeah.
Which is great. I don't need another 2D Mario game.
No.
Having a true 3D platformer, I'm excited. But I guess they said they were not going to learn any more about like games or anything this year. So
yeah. When is this coming out?
We'll see. March.
You think they would say something. Like, right? Like,
well, March? I think the game thing is funny because I guess whoever puts out Skyrim had to put out all this stuff going like, hey, like we haven't confirmed Skyrim for Wii U or whatever, or Switch. We have Skyrim HD coming out on consoles and Steam soon. Like, I guess they want people to focus on like, hey, we've got, you know, we need to sell this HD copy we're putting out like in a month. Stop telling people about it coming to the Wii U or Switch.
That's kind of interesting. But you know, someone said this in the chat, you know, I said like, whatever with these third party, you know, I'm not looking for third parties on, but you know, I have to say maybe a convincing factor would be that they're portable, you know, maybe Skyrim, this new Skyrim HD, if it does come out on the
thing, gotta be
the... maybe that's something I would rather play portably rather than sit at home. Cause there are games that are like, sometimes when games get remastered, it's like, I've already sat on my couch and played through this once. I don't want to necessarily commit the time to that, but maybe if I, you know, just fucking around at the office, I can play it again. You know, like maybe, I don't know. It's going to be good for Monster Hunter.
Oh, finally. I can play that game.
But anyway.
Yeah. When you said big video game news, I assumed you were talking about Red Dead Redemption 2. But
what is?
I thought this was bigger. But Red Dead is...
That comes out in a year from now. So they should... The internet was on fire about that. And I never... For the record, I never played the first one. I wanted to. And I am excited about this game. I'm going to play this one. But man, everyone was really excited for an image, I thought.
I think people have been just clamoring for that for so long.
I didn't know. I didn't know that first one was such a big deal.
I played the game and I loved it.
Yeah.
But yeah, I did not know how much fever there was for this.
Well, really now that Westworld's out, now I'm all into like Western shit.
I don't play open world games that much, nor Rockstar games, honestly. But this being a big ass Western on the new consoles, I think I have to try that.
Yeah, I really want.
It's Rockstar's first game on the new consoles, isn't it?
Oh wow!
I think I have to play that.
Oh yeah,
I think I'm gonna have to check that out.
Yeah.
But it was weird that trailer and all that stuff came out the morning of the Nintendo stuff. It was like, how did a random Thursday somehow collect all these things? Like, it just seemed funny.
What did they just put up? I only saw like a red image, then an image with a sun, and then four people standing there.
And then it said 2017.
Is there any footage or anything?
Yes, there's a lot of footage.
There's gameplay and stuff?
Yeah.
Oh, I haven't even seen this.
I haven't seen it either, honestly.
Garrett, you're missing out.
I know.
Hey, Garrett, get in or get out.
I'm trying.
Yeah. So that's video games. Is there anything else you guys want to talk about with video games?
No.
Yeah, I really haven't had that much time with VR yet.
Enough
video games. Hey, I want to thank our sponsors. Yeah. That's right. We got them. You didn't think we did? We do.
We're so fucking cool. We got them.
I want to say primarily, I want to thank our best sponsor up front.
You can't.
Which
say
will
who's
always
best.
Yeah, I choose favorites.
You favorite?
I'm going to pick our favorite sponsor.
I'm in dad mode with sponsors where I love all of them equally, but just different.
I think saying you're in dad mode is cool.
Put that on.
Thank you.
I remember being at the launch of the PSP with Chaz.
Yeah.
The night it came out, being outside Walmart, and a woman walked up and said, I don't know how many they have in there, but I'm in grandma mode. And I will.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And I will get them for my grandchildren, just letting you boys know. And it's like, we were here an hour before you.
Using that term legitimately is
pretty you told me about that. I remember that old lady, that's a threat.
Yeah.
She threatened you in the
grandma. I'm just fucking telling you right now. I'm in grandma mode.
You don't want to see me in grandma mode.
You should have knocked her the fuck out.
Yeah, you get my good books. I can be a nice
I'm
guy.
I'm getting the fucking thing.
You hit me in grandma mode, I'll fucking kill
I'm
you.
I'm getting the new Nintendo and you can't stop me.
That was 12 years ago. She's still in grandma mode?
12 years ago.
She's hopefully she's 12 feet under
mode. She's in soil mode.
Soil mode. 12 feet under.
I buried
the
twice
job.
As deep.
I'm not coming back.
Anyway, I want to thank our favorite sponsor, which is always you folks at home watching us.
Oh, wow.
Because, hey, we had MEGA64 Once Upon a Time, our new Blu-ray set that we've been working on. We put it up for pre-order this week. And in fact, tonight, as of this... If you're watching this live on Sunday...
Sorry, people watching on Tuesday.
Sorry,
again,
Tuesday,
once
people.
Again, sorry, YouTube people.
Too bad.
But if you're watching this live on Sunday, tonight is the last night to pre-order our Blu-ray box set. And you could pre-order either just the box set or the box set with a shirt, the poster, all that good stuff. Go to shop.mega64.com. Tonight's your last night to pre-order.
Right.
And remember, we always like to throw in a little thank you. You know, there's probably a little bonus thing. Whatever you'll get for pre-ordering that other people
what
won't get.
What is that noise?
Whatever.
Well, I don't want to hype it up like, hey, you're going to get a car.
But
or
again,
something.
I want to say I'm sorry to a majority of our audience watching on YouTube. You missed the boat. Once again.
So anyway, for some bonus stuff and some probably a lot faster shipping, things like that, pre-order it tonight. And I really want to say thank you to everybody who did it because as of this last Friday, the Blu-ray is done.
Oh.
No. I finished it, got that, threw that sumbitch on a hard drive, and drove to the Blu-ray factory, kicked
you
the door open, and
yourself.
I said, hey, I'm in fucking grandpa mode. Print this shit.
Whoa. And, what is that called when you give something the product to
Author?
Get printed?
Grandpa mode.
It goes into replication.
Yeah, but like, it's like a term like, oh, it's gone this.
It's gone
like,
gold.
It's gone gold.
It's gone gold.
Gone gold.
So we've gone gold.
Yes, we've gone gold.
Yeah, we went gold. Nothing else went gold. We went
now,
gold.
Now, I heard something else went gold this week. I want to bring it up. You know, maybe we could talk a little more about video games.
I guess.
No, I don't. Yeah. Honestly, no. I don't think anything needs to. No.
Yeah. That the last Guardian has gone gold.
Oh, so the
now,
same
if
thing.
If you want to cut, Eric, cut to yourself.
Yeah,
you
go
have
ahead.
Anything to add to?
Yeah, it's not out. It's never coming out. I guess we can make anything gold. I already told you this. Wishes and Bigfoot are gold. Who gives a shit? Nothing matters. That's
are
not
they
it's real.
Gold?
All right. If well,
how is a wish gold?
Some wishes come.
I don't know. How is the last Guardian
the man
gold?
Who runs? Who's running this very podcast? Says words don't matter. So let's just. You know what, Eric? Blah 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 blah.
Blah. Yeah.
Talk gibberish. I mean, it doesn't matter. I mean, Eric. It all means something, or nothing means something.
Nothing means something.
I wanted to
cut this
talking
whole
in
part
gibberish.
Out. That is. embarrassing. Anyway, okay, so. Anyway, our Blu-ray is done. So we have gone gold. And
gold, baby.
Because of the pre-orders, we're going to, this coming week, we can decide how many they're going to make and things like that. It really helped, it really
that
helped us
helps
out
a lot.
And it helped us make the whole package better. So thank you to everybody. So get that in tonight. And also, don't forget, while you're at shop.mega64.com, we also have the experiment sweatshirt is still in stock.
Oh, thank God. Finally.
It is still in stock because
it's sweater weather, guys.
Because guess what? We printed a ton of them this time.
Yeah.
I hate when things sell out in 10 seconds. So
yeah,
those are...
I like it because I'm greedy.
There you go.
But, it's like if they sell out in a day, well, you had a day. But when they sell out in 10 seconds, you didn't have a chance.
Yeah.
So they're still up. Go get those if you haven't gotten one. Anyway, that's that. But I also want to give a shout out to Kickapoo Joy Juice, our good friends at Kickapoo Joy Juice. They are making a soda unlike any other. They are making revolutionary fluids over there. You can just suck them down and slurp them down because they are delectable.
And as Garrett has said many times, it's made with real cane sugar, not that high fructose.
Yeah, you don't want that.
You don't want that. Yeah. If you have a cavity, cane sugar you can handle, but the fructose is what gets you. It gets right up to the nerve and it just goes right to your brain. It fucks you up.
I look forward to that. You know, I like to have a cheat day, and I usually pick, you know, Sunday night. I come do the podcast, have a cheat day, have a Kickapoo, real cane sugar. But I would be amiss. There's none in the fridge.
Well, we drink them all.
Well, all right, Kickapoo.
There it is. Anyway, go to drinkkickapoo.com and you can get one for yourself.
I'm going to Amazon to get some.
You can get a case on Amazon. And
I'll follow them on Twitter.
Follow at drinkkickapoo on Twitter, and they'll help you out. We also want to thank SumoLounge.com.
I love SumoLounge.com.
They make the best chairs on earth. We look miserable. We look fucking miserable because we're not sitting on a Sumo Lounge chair. That's right. Get yourself a Sumo tonight. Go to SumoLounge.com. Pick one up for yourself. It's delightful.
Your ass will thank you later.
Your ass will say, thank you, and give you a little kiss back there if it's clean. But call me... What is that album? Call me... Janet, if you're nasty.
Miss Jackson, if you're nasty.
Miss Jackson, if you're nasty.
Remember when she pulled her titty out on the
Justin Timberlake pulled her titty out.
You remember when she pulled her titty out?
Justin removed also, a panel of the clothing.
My favorite thing about that is that they said it was an accident. It was not an accident.
That's totally a lie.
What was the...
They like, just lied.
Yeah, they just lied.
It was him going like this and then pulling it down.
It was a choreographed move.
It was a move that they wanted to do.
And then the fucking news and everyone that aired it, they fed into the lie and told us that lie.
Yeah, the wardrobe malfunction became a huge thing.
Oh, it used to. You used to just be able to get away with shit. Now we got WikiLeaks. 2016, guys.
There you go.
Yeah.
Hey, we got a package.
No.
Is it there? Is it over there?
Yes.
We got a package from these guys before. I shaved earlier.
We
got a package. Yeah, these guys have sent us a package before.
Oh, yeah.
These guys are Universal Yums.
These have been here for a year. I'm taking them home.
Universal Yums has sent us a package. Do we have, like, a cutting tool here?
Oh, yeah. You know I got a cutting tool.
Boy, I wonder if Garrett has a knife.
And I want to say thanks to them.
Yeah.
I don't know how this works. I'm scared.
I want to watch you open it. You just push. Push up.
Can you have that?
Like that?
Is that legal?
Yeah.
You shouldn't show that. You can't.
No, you shouldn't show that.
Live from Arizona.
We're keeping this in Canada this week.
Garrett,
our old Canadian studio.
No, you shouldn't show that.
What backwards swap meet did you get that from?
No, that's obtained through a special permitting site that I know.
Okay. Okay, bro.
Okay, Rocco, yep. go ahead and sheath it.
I'm scared. Okay,
he's got to hold the button and push it back in.
Anyway, our friends at Universal Yums sent us a package, and the theme of this month's box is Thailand.
Whoa!
Oh, yeah.
I've never been there.
You know who's from there, Sean?
No.
Sagat.
Oh. Okay.
That's true.
Tiger.
Yeah. Okay. So we got some.
I haven't had dinner. I'm pretty stoked on it.
Oh yeah.
Hot chili flavor. I don't know if these are chips. I don't know what these are.
Yeah, they're like little like
some kind of twist.
Like baked fry things.
Non-fried.
This has a bunch of stuff on it.
Wow.
Strawberry.
I see a tomato. Yeah.
Strawberry and
tomato. Strawberry.
Oh, get ready for strawberry, Sean.
It's not.
Whoa.
It's not at all a strawberry.
Coated peanuts. These are sesame peanuts. I'm trying these.
Whoa.
Dude,
start opening.
Dude, they got matcha green tea Pocky. Yeah,
that comes from Thailand?
Yeah, I know you're a Pocky man.
I'm a Pocky man. I'll open this one up.
Pretz, they got Tom Yum flavored?
Pretz.
Who the hell's Tom Yum?
I've had that soup at a Thai restaurant before.
Tom Yum?
Tom Yum soup is
Who's
good.
Who's Tom Yum?
Like
is that
coconut.
Like Tom Jones? Anyway. And then we got all kinds of stuff in here. There's all kinds of like tea drinks in here.
Oh shit. Anyway. Tea drinks?
Yes.
Whoa.
What is this? Big roll. A grilled seaweed roll. Garrett, that's on you.
Yeah, all right. I'll do that.
Anyway, Universal Yums, what they did is they gave us a link that if you want to click the link, you can subscribe and you get a deal on like getting this every month and stuff like that. So if you want to subscribe,
I know you like Pocket.
Look that link, but it was kind of a complicated link, so you just have to like look in the info.
It's in the chat if you're live, and it's in the description if you're watching later.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hit that description.
Man, this is fucking great. Cool.
But, we're big time,
thank
man.
Thank you, Universal.
Yeah, we get snacks, we get drinks.
Eric, come on.
I'm going to try a sesame nut.
What else do you need in this world but snacks, drinks, and chairs?
Take them. Chili's good.
Friends?
Oh, I don't have those. No. I don't have any of those.
Oh, this is a weird consistency.
Yeah, but it's cool, huh?
Like a wheat.
Whoa.
Like a puffed wheat.
These are sesame nuts.
Let me get a sesame nut.
Anyways.
I love snacks.
Shouts out.
I'm going to do the seaweed roll.
Okay.
Oh, legit.
Anyway.
Whoa.
Thank you
That's
to them.
That's just straight up seaweed.
Is this just seaweed? Nothing
That's
else?
Just straight seaweed. Oh.
That was good.
Delicious.
Is it?
Oh my God, it's so good.
Really?
What?
It's like barbecue sauce flavor.
Coconut chips?
Coconut chips?
Oh, and it's fishy as fuck.
Oh.
I love it.
Oh, fuck that.
It's super fishy.
Oh, I'll give a little bite.
Hey, crunch on the other end if you want. Yeah.
Okay.
Look at that. Is this like the ASMR section of the cast?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Mm. It's very fishy. Very fishy.
It's seaweed.
Yeah.
This is called garlic bread.
Oh! Yeah, open some garlic bread.
I love snacks.
I love snacks too.
These sesame nuts are awesome. Anyway, they're kind of spicy.
How's your garlic bread?
I'm gonna choke.
Sweet.
No.
What? Damn. Oh. It was a mistake for them to send us this.
Yeah.
This is the rest of the podcast.
Right?
Look at these tomato chips. Not strawberry.
I do want to try those tomato chips.
Not strawberry.
Well, you know, there's
I'm
a whole...
sorry we're spending so much time eating snacks.
Oh!
No, but there's a big community out there that likes, like, to watch people eat.
It's like ketchup on their fry.
Even pay for people, like, feeders. They pay for people to eat.
Doesn't Twitch have, like, social eating now?
Yeah.
What?
No, yeah. And you can... feeders watch...
Ah.
And then they like, send girls a credit card number.
It tastes just like, It's exactly like ketchup.
Yeah.
And they just Amazon Fresh stuff over to their streaming
anyone
house.
Anyone else want to eat these? Anyone else want to eat these before they're gone?
I want it.
You want to be a feeder?
I want to be a... yeah.
Or do you want to get fed?
I want to get fed.
Well, I don't know if you've got the hips for it.
Why not? Anyways.
So good.
Anyways,
hey, good. This week I saw a movie.
What did you see?
That all was right. So good, and it made me sad.
Oh. Okay.
I saw Pop Star by The Lonely Island.
You did?
Oh, yeah.
That movie was so good.
Was it?
That movie was so funny.
Really?
And good. And it only makes you sad when you read how much it bombed.
Yeah.
But I fully blind bought it. I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I like The Lonely Island. I bought the Blu-ray when it came out. Hadn't seen it. And it was a genuinely really good movie. And what made it so good, it's done like a fake documentary.
Right.
It's all like kind of... those documentaries like you get for like Katy Perry or Justin Bieber or whatever about Connor for real.
Yeah.
Andy Samberg's character. And what made it so good was the interviews they got were not like, oh, here's a Lonely Island guy in a funny wig talking about him.
Right.
Every interview was 50 Cent.
Huh.
Simon Cowell, Ringo Starr.
Whoa.
Wasn't it? You know what I mean? It was all like legitimate people in music.
Yeah.
Talking about sincere shit about the dumbest stuff.
Wow.
You know, and it was really, really funny. It was really good. And it made me feel bad that like, it was like, wow, this.
Yeah, he went you know, on a lot of stuff to promote it too.
Yeah, they haven't had a good luck with their movies.
No, not at all.
Huh.
But yeah, it was really, really.
They're digital shorts though. That's where it's at.
But it's really sad because they made like, a ton of music videos for just this movie.
Right.
Like, throughout the movie, there are music videos.
Oh, really?
They made a bunch surrounding it, and so, like, their plan was to, like, okay, well, this is our biggest thing. We're going to all out assault, like...
put an album out for the soundtrack.
Yeah. So, I mean, the album came out. The album has 28 tracks on it.
Whoa!
It's like a fucking two-disc thing. Like, they made so much material around this character in this movie, and it's like... did you know that came out? Did you know they had an album that big? You know what I mean?
No, and I liked Lonely Island stuff.
Yeah. Anyway.
I honestly, really I'm kind of turned off to that whole, even though it's a parody of that, I don't like that Kim Kardashian, like, rich rapper celebrity bullshit. Like, I don't like that.
Yeah.
So, even if it's a parody of it. It's like, I don't want to watch 2 hours of this.
But also, too, it was rated R, so it's also like even more kind of eliminating an audience that might identify with it at all.
Was it worth it for the R rating? Hmm? Was it like definitely an R, or could they have made it PG-13?
There is one scene that has like a dick in it.
Oh, right.
Outside of that, it really wasn't that.
Well, that's not worth it.
And, you know, they said fuck sometimes. Okay, that was, you know, but not, there isn't really anything else that made me, that was like, yeah, this, good, it's rated R, you know.
Yeah. Huh.
But I really liked it. I thought it was really good.
Yorma, Keeve, Andy, shouts out.
Did you?
Sorry, guys. I gotta watch it.
Yeah, I'm curious. Really good. I watched, you said Ringo, I watched Ron Howard's documentary on the Beatles, 8 Days a Week, that came out on Hulu.
Yeah.
It was really good. It showed me, though, it's just them like during their touring years.
Yeah.
You never want to be that famous. That's a fucking curse. Like, that sucks. Like, seeing, like, how crazy it was, and they had to be, like, put in, like, meat trucks and, like, hide in the back and then drip. Like, it's like, no one wants to live like this. Like, you go all, like, all over the world to go to a hotel room to not be able to leave the hotel room. Like, it's fucking nightmare. So... It was really good, though. It was really interesting just, like, watching, like, them, like, why they stopped touring, why they, you know, how big it was, they stopped touring, and then, like, them moving on past that, and that's kind of the end. But it was really cool. I really enjoyed it. So, check it out. I heard that, I don't know if you guys care about this at all, but Christopher Guest has a new movie they put on Netflix.
Christopher Guest?
Guest? Is it Guest? Yeah. Guest? Guest?
Oh. Guest, whatever. Yeah.
But, called Mascots?
Yes. Just,
it's oh, yeah, I've seen that advertised on Netflix. Really? Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't seen it, but... I love his stuff. I didn't realize that he was making movies just for them now, so that's kind of
cool. Yeah, I heard it is not funny.
Oh. Mm. You know what?
I've heard from a lot of people.
That doesn't surprise me.
Uh-oh. You know, their best one was Best in Show. We all know it. And then
Spinal Tap's pretty good.
Oh, Spinal Tap is great.
Did you hear about the latest with Spinal Tap?
Yeah.
What's going on? Harry Shearer is
suing him.
What?
Like Universal or whoever.
Hey, good. For what?
He basically said he has not gotten anything from Spinal Tap, like, since it came out, money-wise, you know, whatever. And he said, with a lot of these contracts, you have the right to, like, audit them, basically. Mm-hmm. Like, okay, I'm going, like, I'm going to put in the work. I want to audit, like, what you earned and where, you know, whatever. He doesn't need the money, but he just thought, this is weird.
This is a very common thing that a lot of contracts have, where they...
Yeah.
In the end, they come up saying, well, we didn't make any money. We actually lost money in the promotion and all these other things. So you never, even though you got like in your contract points or something on this, they don't honor it.
Yeah.
And I remember, he's like, hey, I'm not going to stand for it.
Somebody from CKY talked about that. I want to say maybe it was Jess or somebody from the band CKY is they still get a thing from their old record label every month. And it still says, oh, you haven't paid back the, you know. $30 million for all your tours. And he's like, now what costs $30 million in our tour? I can tell you right now the cost of everything. Like, he's like,
right.
I was there. I know the cost of everything. There's no, where are they getting that number?
And
he's never
accounting.
Gotten anything, you know, or something like that. I might be making that up. But anyway, but Harry Shearer was like, he investigated all these overseas companies that are overseeing, like, you know, when it re-airs, when it plays on Netflix, stuff
Blu-ray
like that.
Blu-ray sales.
And he says, like, in 22 years, in the past 22 years, they made, on the books, they say they made $86. Like, when he dug into it, it was amounts that are, like, that isn't true. Like, in 22 years, made $86?
Because he didn't just act in it. He made this movie with Christopher Guest and with, you know, was more than just an actor in it.
So anyway, whatever. Long story short, he went, and that was merchandise sales, and then like home video rights, they made like $94.
Oh, wow.
And so it was like, so I looked at all that, and I decided I'm suing this company for, I don't remember how much, but it was many, many, many millions.
Hmm.
And again, I don't think he needs it. I think it's just a matter of
Spinal Tap is a big movie. That's like that's like a comedy classic.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess it wasn't, was it a big deal when it came out? I don't know, but everyone knows Spinal Tap.
Yeah, I'm curious. Was it a big deal, or was it just the matter of like?
I was too young when that came out.
Classic after,
you know.
Well, anyways, if you haven't seen Spinal Tap, check it out.
Yeah, it's a rockumentary.
Yeah, Spinal Tap is. I was never a big. What was that one?
Wade for Guffman.
Yeah, I was never that big.
I liked it. I liked that one.
But I liked Spinal Tap. But my favorite was Best in Show.
Best in Show is a high praise, but. Yeah.
Yeah. Mighty Win.
Mighty Win was terrible.
Didn't care.
And then I think, was that the last one they did? Or was there another one?
I feel like they did one since, but I could be wrong.
And this is like a group of, like, when you watch these movies, It's like all improv. A majority of it's all improv, and they're just like fucking around like with their character.
About all.
And it's really greatest, cool.
Levy,
Eugene Levy.
Eugene Levy.
Catherine O'Hare.
Yeah.
O'Hare.
Yeah.
Catherine O'Hare. Parker Posey. Yeah. Anyways,
it's
super funny.
They're all good. I haven't seen most of them, but Best in Show is really, really
Fred
fun.
Willard.
Actually, A Mighty Wind wasn't even good because I did not like it.
No, terrible. That's terrible.
So anyway, yeah, I haven't checked out Mascots, but that's what I heard about it. The other thing I checked out was, I brought this up the other day, but I saw, you know, getting in the Halloween spirit, you know, whatever, it's approaching. And I saw a movie I had heard about, and it just struck my interest. I'm not that into, like, just me personally, I'm not, like, the biggest horror movie guy, you know. I like the big ones like The Shining and, you know, stuff that have a weight to it. I've never been like a Friday the 13th, got to watch all 18 of them kind of guy. You know, whatever. I have respect for it. They're fun. But whatever. But when I heard that the third Halloween movie had nothing to do with Michael Myers, and it was about an evil, like, mask maker who was trying to get kids to put on fucked up masks to like, turn them into worms and shit, I was like, I need to see this right now. I watched Halloween 3, Season of the Witch. It has nothing to do with Michael Myers, as I said.
Mm-hmm.
And it was 100%, it was like a Goosebumps book. I mean, it was like a doctor going, what the, like, they keep playing this commercial on TV that's it's to the tune of London Bridges. This is Halloween, Halloween, Halloween. And it's just like an 8-bit pumpkin going in and out like that. It's like something we would have done for Gamer Wars. It's so fucking goofy. And then he finds out, there's this company selling these masks. If the kid is wearing the mask when that comes on TV, it turns them into fucking...
Whoa.
Like, a ghoulie? Like you, they show an example of what will happen, and they, like, a kid turns into like a bunch of bugs. I can't even really tell you why they wanted to do that.
A kid turns into
bugs. Other than they just fucked everything up.
Bugs. And he's spiders now.
Anyway, I don't want to spoil. There's a plot thing I want to say, but I don't know if people out there want to go in cold. But I just want to say,
go ahead and
Stonehenge is involved.
Oh,
dude.
Please spoil this fucking movie.
Stonehenge is involved.
It's also involved.
That's all I really need to say. No, please tell me all about it. I want to know about the kids who turn into bugs.
These masks have fragments of Stonehenge in them.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God.
So that they can use a signal to warp these kids into bugs.
Where the demons dance.
Or something. But anyway, You should watch it. It's so out of left field, bizarre.
And this is the only Halloween without Michael Myers in it, right?
Yes. And what's hilarious is, of course, what happens. He goes to a bar. The main character goes into a bar. And on TV is... Michael Myers.
Oh, yeah.
Turn that off. Oh, and they change the channel. It's like...
Fuck you.
And so the movie, it's funny and it's fun. Find it if you can, but... Shout Factory made a Blu-ray because, like, no, the studio won't even touch it.
Wow.
People in the chat are like, Rocco's making shit up. I promise. I'm not. But find this movie, and on the Blu-ray that Shout Factory did, the best part is you got the movie. It's fun to watch, whatever. This awesome documentary they made with it. I love when documentaries are honest about movies. It's not just, oh, I loved working with so-and-so. No, I want the real shit. And this... documentary that Shout Factory did is so good because cuts to one producer and he goes, yeah, basically our thing was, you know, okay, we did two huge movies with Michael Myers. We wanted to turn Halloween into a franchise that every Halloween we put out a new Halloween movie and they're more centered around scary shit around Halloween. Like maybe there will be another one with Michael Myers later, but you know, every year you get a different subject. This year's about these masks. Next year's about something.
You know,
we wanted to make it like the Twilight Zone.
Idea is kind of cool.
Yeah,
like
I totally agree.
It is it's a great idea for something that's not a non like that's not like an established brand.
That's it.
Yes.
If it was called something else and they did that now every year and it was like, oh, I knew what's coming out. I'd be into it.
Yeah. And so then they cut to the other producer who goes, I think it was fucking stupid. We created an iconic movie character, and then someone tells me we're not using him. The most positive thing I could say is the check I got for this movie. No one consulted me. I think it was a fucking terrible idea. I think it's stupid. This movie's called Halloween 3 Season of the Witch. Put out a movie called Season of the Witch, and it's about this, and everyone remembers it fondly. No, it's part of Halloween, and now everyone laughs at it. It's fucking stupid. Then they cut to the other producer. You know, it was... We should have called it Season of the Witch. Yeah, we should have called it Halloween 3. But it's still a good
Even
movie.
Even if it was called Season of the Witch, and then every year was a new Season of the Witch or something stupid.
Yeah,
who cares?
Yeah, start it with that one.
Yeah.
But either way, that was what they tried to do. It failed. They retreated from that plan.
I've always heard the name, but I've never even like heard anything from the plot of it even. That's insane.
Well, it has an awesome... Now, the one thing I could say that's legitimately good, non-facetiously, the soundtrack. I'm pretty sure John Carpenter did the soundtrack.
He came back to do the soundtrack?
It is all synthy, crazy shit. It's awesome.
Oh, all right.
So it's worth looking at. It sounds like the Main Street Electrical Parade from hell.
Whoa.
It's awesome. So anyway, check it out, at least for that. But Season of the Witch, if you want to watch a bizarre... And it also has my kind of ending. Oh, that ending. And when it happens, you're just like... It's not over. Oh, wow. It's fucking... Wow.
What is it? You can say it.
You can tell me.
Say the ending, please.
I can't.
You can. Oh. Just say you're going to spoil it and then wave your hands when you're done.
Okay. Everybody at home, I'm going to spoil the ending.
Oh, yeah.
I'll do this when I'm done.
Okay.
They uncover this whole plan that they're going to play TV commercials.
Who is they?
This evil company.
Stonehenge.
They put out the masks. Now Halloween is here. And they keep playing the commercials. 3 days until Halloween, 2 days until... And then Halloween, they tell other kids, you got to be at home at 9 p.m. to see the awesome payoff to this thing, this promo. I don't know.
Put on your mask.
And so, yeah. And so this whole time, he's wrestling with, oh, fuck, I got to... You know, I got to get them to not play these commercials. And it's kind of like almost like no one wants to not play a commercial. It's like, well, they're paying us to do it. Right. No, it doesn't matter. It's going to fuck up all these kids. You can't. You cannot play it. You can't. And they think he's crazy. Well, all this crazy shit happens by the end of the movie. And it gets to the end. I'm telling you, this is my kind of ending. You might not care for it. I loved it. He gets to, they destroy this factory. Okay, but then he goes outside and it's like all the kids have the masks.
Yeah,
How can you stop that? Too late. He goes to this gas station and they're handing out stuff. Oh, look, it's 9 p.m. And they turn on the TV. Get ready, kids, look. And it's like when they flash the pumpkin, this 8-bit pumpkin, these kids are fucked.
Right.
It hasn't gotten to that part yet. It's about to zoom in. And the guy gets on the phone, and he's like, hello, NBC, you got to take this off. You have to. Stop arguing with me. You have to. A lot of kids are going to die. I don't care. Tell your boss it's a bomb. It's a fucking bomb. I don't care what you tell him. Pull it. Like, he's just making shit up to get him to not play it.
Yeah.
Come on. And then he looks up. We're sorry. Technical difficulties have prevented us. Oh, fuck. The kid gawks over, changes the channel. Oh, what the fuck? Okay. No, don't play it on the thing. Don't play it on the thing. We're sorry. Technical difficulty. Oh, thank you. Kid changes the channel. Fuck! Don't play it! Don't play it! We're sorry. Thank God. Changes the channel. Oh, my God!
Just keep
Don't
happening.
Fucking play it! Turn it off! And here it is. The pumpkin starts flashing. Turn it off! I said turn it off! Credits.
Credits. Oh, my God. Good ending.
Any other thing would have set up a fucking franchise or a bow on it. You know what I mean?
Man.
There you go.
Do it so many times.
Oh, my God.
Credits. Oh,
wow.
So go find that movie.
Wow. Apparently, that's also really good muted. They said that it was a funny thing to watch anyway. So we nailed it. That is amazing.
I wasn't joking when I say, I always make that joke about credits.
Yeah.
It goes to the synth-like music.
Oh, that's great.
So good.
Oh, my God.
It's so good. Anyway. Wow. All right, I'm all done.
Watch that movie. Halloween, what, 3?
Halloween 3.
Season of the Witch.
Mm.
Anyway.
Yeah, that was a performance.
I'm tired after
that. Dude, yeah, I thought you hurt your voice. I watched a couple movies last night.
Mm.
Watch Night of the Creeps.
Oh, yeah.
I know you love Carousel of Death.
Yeah. It has the same star. Halloween 3, the main guy is the detective.
It's the
in
same
that
detective.
Movie.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Okay. Fuck. That movie I hadn't seen since, I don't even, since the Banana Video days, in all honesty.
Yeah.
But, Classic Banana Video era. Super good. Super good. I'm trying to, I've been so freaking busy, I haven't watched, like, hardly anything yet.
Yeah.
And we're already freaking 22 days in.
Oh, I know.
Mm-hmm. What is it? It is, it doesn't matter. 23rd. Shit. So I'm like, I'm four Halloween movies in. I need to watch some more.
Wow. Can I go back to that movie real quick?
Yeah.
Why is it called Season of the Witch?
Because it's the time of year.
Oh, okay. I just thought there was like a real reason.
Does the witch make
There's
the
There's no witches.
Masks?
No?
Okay. All right.
God.
It's just that time of year.
Okay.
Hey, we got a lot of stuff in the works this week. A lot of big Mega 64 stuff. I want to say thank you again to everyone, like I said, who supported us and like pre-ordered the Blu-ray and even just, you know, promoted the stuff that we always post. You know, people who just do that on a daily basis. I can't thank you enough. We're working on a bunch of stuff. We got some video things in the works. Video things, as if that's something we've ever done. Mm. Videos in the works, format. Things like that. So we should end it here and get to work on those things.
Okay.
But I feel like, can we just do a real quick grand finale?
Yeah.
Real quick grand finale.
Grand finale.
I feel like the people have earned it. I've been just feeling such a positivity the past couple weeks. Let's just give it to them. Let's just do it.
Okay.
Will I am, idiot he is.
What?
I'm a star, cause I made it. I'm rich, and I'm famous. Woo! Donald Trump said to grab your body, but Donald Trump said to grab your body, but yeah, baby, I'm a star, and I'm famous. Woo! Donald Trump said to grab your body, but Donald Trump said to
grab him by the pussy.
No, you got it all wrong.
Okay, so that's a clip I just wanted to point out. That is a clip
of
Will I Am's new song.
Yeah.
I don't want to watch
Grab him by the pussy is what it's called?
Garrett.
You don't want to watch that?
I saw that, like, being thrown out, posted everywhere, and I was like, well, there's no fucking way I'll click on that.
But Garrett.
What?
There's more.
What?
So.
Trump that, bitch.
What?
Okay, it's obvious. I don't look like Donald Trump.
Oh.
But what's more obvious is Donald Trump does not look like the president of the United States of America.
What?
Nor should he be. If this was a TV show, maybe I would watch it. It would be pretty funny.
Yeah.
If it was a movie, I would probably spend my money to go and see this circus of a show.
Yeah, me too, I would.
But this is not a circus, a TV show, or a movie. This is real life
with
real life problems.
Oh my God, I'm so glad he clarified
it. I'm glad that he told me that this was real.
Because now it's obvious if you saw that. He does not look like Donald Trump.
He does not.
That was a parody. Eric, it was a parody.
Parody.
Oh.
It was a parody.
Like what does the what does the president look like?
Not like
that.
Not like Trump.
Not like Donald Trump. Not a man wearing a wig.
Barack Obama does not look like Trump.
No.
That's true.
They don't look like each other at all.
I've thought about that before. I have.
So anyway, just he gave some clarification, and I think we can go. I think we should all go into the polls.
Know him.
Knowing what he did.
So are we supposed to vote for Will I Am?
Yeah.
Yes, I think.
Write his name in.
I think so. Is that what we're doing?
Yeah,
that's
we're
what
definitely
we're supposed
writing.
To do, right?
Well, I'm writing an Apple.
What?
The other
his
guy.
Kid's name.
Oh, Apple the App?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I think yeah.
Okay.
Is that what he named his kid Apple?
Apple the App.
I'm sorry,
is
Garrett.
His coworker.
Garrett, do you think that his child is named Apple the App?
That's
I'm talking about the other one of the other members of the Black Eyed Peas.
Gwyneth Paltrow has a kid.
Wait. There's Fergie.
Yeah.
There's Will I Am.
Yeah.
There's two other members?
Yes, that is
Camera
correct.
On him. See if he can get him.
Okay. There it is.
Garrett will
can
get
I see a photo of that?
Garrett will get a prize if he can name
no.
this.
Yep.
Well, apparently one is Apple the App.
Yeah.
Apple the App.
See the one with the...
There we go.
Okay. So we got
Name the last guy.
Yeah.
Apple the App's in the middle then.
Yep.
Oh, I thought he was... Okay. That guy
that
is...
That guy needs more holsters.
That guy's name is...
Uh-huh. Go ahead.
Z Shizor, but it's spelled X I Right? It's not
Shadows of the Black Eyed Peas.
Shizor? I don't know what the fuck.
Hey,
final answer?
I don't know. Is
his name is Taboo? You fucking idiot!
Taboo, of course.
Shizor?
You fucking moron!
Of course, it's
close
Taboo.
Up on Garrett. Apologize.
Shizor,
I'm sorry, Taboo.
We're gonna end tonight's podcast on a Taboo apology. So anyway, good night, everybody.
Taboo, we're so sorry.
Kiss, kiss, Taboo. Sorry. Thought you were Shizor. I don't know.
A little more.
Looked like a Shizor. A little more authentic. Yeah. Look, Taboo. I didn't really mean it. I thought that me and you could kind of work this out with just a simple, I'm sorry, but apparently that you have had your feelings hurt and you're going to require a little more coaxing. So, hey, Taboo, I'm down on my knees. Taboo, I'm down on my knees. I'm begging you, please, Taboo, forgive me. Shizor, ain't going to cut it. Taboo, that's for you, baby. Good night, and I do apologize. Fergie, I have a picture. Taboo and me, that's who's in my wallet. I got a picture of him.
Okay, and now Garrett's Black Eyed Peas tribute. Good night.
Like,
what are you saying? You don't like what?
I don't like being put on the spot, but.
No, you were prepared for this, I thought. We warned
for the
you
Black
ahead
Eyed
of time.
Peas tribute?
Yeah, we warned
All
you.
All I know is the song, you can't say Get Retarded in here. You can't sing that.
But they did it.
You just did.
I did, but I did. Kevin's going to cut that out later.
Yeah, Kevin's going to cut that out.
we're not taking calls from Scott.
Oh,
come
no.
on. Why is it always on me? You know I have the most guilt about being white, Eric, and you always play it on me.
He's very guilty. He's very guilty.